In this video, I will show you two different ways how you can create vertical videos for your Instagram Reels and YouTube Shorts from your horizontal YouTube videos in DaVinci Resolve. Hey guys, this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's take a new project and get started. Alright, so this is DaVinci Resolve 18.5, and before we get started, we have to do some basic setting as usual. So click on the setting button in the corner. First of all, we have to set the size of this Instagram reel. So in this case, I am using 1920 by 1080, which is the full HD resolution. But if you want to create this reel in 4K resolution, you only have to select the Ultra HD option from here in the timeline resolution. And now we have to do one more important thing. As you can see here, we have an option that is use vertical resolution. If you want to create Instagram reel or YouTube shorts, you have to check this option for vertical resolution, because Instagram and YouTube shorts supports vertical resolution, not the horizontal. As you can see, this is the horizontal resolution, so you have to convert this into a vertical resolution. So simply check this option. In this case, I am using 24 frames per second for cinematic, and click on save. Now let's import our video clips. So it's very simple. Just go to the media pool, right click on that, click on import media, and here we have to select the footage. So I'm gonna use this one as well, and this footage. So I have selected three different video clip. You can use any video clip that you like. Click on open. And here we have to drag and drop this video clip on the timeline. So it's very simple again. Just simply select the video clip, drag and drop on the timeline. In this case, I will keep this video 15 seconds long, but you can keep it 30 seconds or 60 seconds for YouTube shorts or Instagram reel. And then you can add a cut just like that. You can select any part of your video clip. Simply, you can delete the unwanted part. And then you can hold alt on the keyboard and scroll up to zoom in. So this is the first video clip. Now you can keep it like this, and then just go to the inspector, and here we have the zoom option. So let's down the zoom value and set it something around 0.3. perfect, and make it like this. This is the second video clip that I am going to use in this Instagram reel. Just simply drag and drop like this. You can minimize, and then you can add a cut at 15 seconds. Just like that, you can delete the video clip. And this is the second one. Let's do the same thing with this one as well. So here we have the zoom. Let's set the value 0.3. Basically, you have to fit this horizontal video clip just like that. And then we have to drag and drop one more video clip. So this is the third one. Let's drag and drop on the timeline. You can minimize it, and then you can cut the extra part just like that. And here we have three different video clips. So just select the top one. Let's set the zoom value 0.3, and then we have to place these video clip vertically. So select the first video clip and place it like this. Select the second one, and here we have the position. Let's move the video clip onto the top, just like that. And here we have to keep in mind, this video clip which is in the center, it should be on the top in the editing timeline, just like that. And then we have to increase the zoom value of this one. So it's very simple. Here we have the zoom. Let's increase the zoom value, and let's zoom it a little bit. So here we have the zoom. Let's set it to 50%. Let's increase the zoom a bit more, just like that. Make sure the black border is visible over here. You can down the size a little bit more. So I'm going to set the value 0.385. perfect. And then you can click on fit button. As you can see, by using this process, you can convert your horizontal YouTube videos into a vertical video for Instagram Reel or YouTube Shorts. It's very simple. And now let me show you how you can create the another design by using the same process. So it's very simple again. just select all the video clip, Control C to copy. I'm gonna paste the same video clip just like that. For the second one, you have to place these video clips just like that. You have to select your top video clip, which is in the center. Right click on that, click on new Fusion clip, and then we have to go on the Fusion page, and here we have the media in and out. So just deattach the media in and out, and what we have to do, just select the media in, add a transform node with this media in, drag and drop to the viewer. You can click on the single viewer, and then you can increase the size of the video clip just a little bit. You can increase the size from here as well. Let's set the value 1.12 or maybe 1.2. Perfect. And now you can rotate the video clip just a little bit. So you can set the angle value maybe 6 degrees. And then let's take a new background node, and I'm going to use this background as a stroke. So what we have to do, let's connect the rectangle with this background, and we have to create a rectangle just like the video clip. So hold Control and scroll up to zoom in, just increase the width value, decrease the height value. Let's rotate this rectangle and fit this rectangle according to the video clip, just like that. Perfect. Now let's merge this background with this one. So it's very simple. Let's take a new merge node. I'm going to use this output as a background. So here we have 4 different points. So the yellow point is for background. Let's connect this yellow point with this one, and I'm going to use this stroke as a foreground. So connect the green foreground point with this one, and here we have the merge one. Let's drag and drop to the viewer. After that, select the rectangle, and here we have to do the important thing, which is the solid. So uncheck the solid option, and here we have the border width. Let's increase the border width. As you can see, we have the black border. If you want to change the color, you can simply select the background and change the color. I'm going to use the white. Hit OK. Now you can down the border width. So I'm going to set the value 0.01, which is looking perfect. Connect the merge one with this media out, and then go to the edit page. And here we have the second design, which is looking like this. As you can see, it's very simple to create in DaVinci Resolve. You can close the inspector window, turn on the loop, go to very first frame of this animation, hit Control F to full screen, and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikash, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.